martial arts to some is a passion, life, and something to strive to be better in to become the greatest in their craft.
But what if, to become the best, you just needed to let the monster inside you come out and let loose? Kind of like these two fighting machines of the demonic proportion.
Akuma, Capcom's most dangerous Street Fighter.
And Kazuya Mishima, Tekken's strongest devil.
He's Demon and I'm Archer.
And it's our job to analyze these characters to their fullest, going through their feats and faults to see what happens when these two fictional characters collide.
To some, this kanji means sky, heaven, and some that will be given great immortality. But to some, it's a greeting to death, the great door to the afterlife when seeing the bearer of the symbol, Akuma.
Oh boy, get ready, folks. This story is full of just pure, uncontained badassness. You see, Akuma, along with his brother Gouken, you know, the guy that dodged Baldi Perv dude last season, was trained under Gotetsu in the way of the Ansatsuken fighting style, better known as the Assassination Fist. A name so badass to know, it's kind of crazy Gouken wasn't in the idea of being used to basically murder your opponents in 100 different ways before they could even fathom what happened.
But Gouken didn't believe in the fighting style's dangerous and deadly ways and decided to more so develop his own fighting style to be a bit more peaceful.
Which is still stupid because most of his own moves seems like they would murder you in 100 of its own less deadly ways. Still didn't help him in the end. Spoiler alert, ahoy.
We are not going through this again, but this ideal splits the brothers into two different paths. While Gouken tried to be one with peace while using the style, which ended him training a few other fighters in it, Akuma embraced its full killing potential, and that's what he did.
Now to start the idea of the Ansatsuken is a major mix of judo, kenpo, and a bit of karate to make a devastating fighting style all about getting up and close and personal with your victim. But that pales in comparison to what he really trained to achieve. See, during his years of training, he learned the power of the Satsui no Hado, aka the literal surge of murderous intent. Hell yeah! Now that's a name for a moveset!
I feel like I should be scared. And to make sure I have everything on while this episode continues, Satsui no Hado. This power gave Akuma many different abilities at his disposal as well. He can shoot Gohadukens, the Goshuriken, which sends enemies flying through the air, the Hayakushu is more of a leg sweep, and the famous word neither of us can say right, the Tatsumaki Zenku Yaku. Huh, I think I actually said that right for once.
See, I told you just need another Street Fighter episode to learn bullshit words. But none of that is compared to Akuma's most prized and iconic move, the Shongoku Satsu, translating to the Raging Demon. Okay, some moves are bullshit to say, but then Akuma just has the most raw fighting move names at the same time. That's just a lucky draw there.
I think you're a little biased.
What? No, come on.
Anyway, the Raging Demon is a move that directly attacks the soul for the poor victim it's aimed at, killing them with the weight of their very own sins all at once. It's the same move he used to kill his master Gotetsu and even Gouken at one point during the rematch. Kinda. He just got back up, but that's for later.
Ha! So it can't affect me! Name one sin I have committed!
Well, for one, you cheated me into a deal that I was on the losing side of from the start. You lock all of our editors and animators into a basement to work for us. You killed me like how many times? You legit gathered souls for a stone a few episodes back. Tried to get revenge on me.
Okay, I get it. But like Archer said, there's only one way to truly defeat the Raging Demon. To get around it, you must empty out your body and soul to fully avoid it. Which is what Gouken kinda did. Yeah, if you remember, Gouken kinda became a ghost by choice for a while to avoid Akuma's full soul murder attempt. Then he came back and helped Ryo for a bit before kinda dicking off for a while Akuma let fully push the Satsui no Hado even further. Which kinda had a side effect.
You see, the Satsui no Hado isn't just a fighting power or a way to brutally kill a victim's soul. It's a full-on living entity itself, slowly pushing the user into a darker path of fighting until it can fully take control. Just like how the being known as Kage did to Ryo, until Ryo rejected Kage and became closer to the power of nothingness. We will explain that more in a later episode.
But if Akuma ever did let the art fully take over, he dons a new form. Bigger, stronger, and a lot more dangerous. The terrifying Oni.
In this form, he's able to cause much more damage and let the full strength of his Satsui no Hado be fully shown. And if you can't tell, Oni is a very fitting name. Because basically an Oni is a creature that in some stories is people who changed into monsters after a lifetime of violent evil. And whereas some depiction usually portray them as red, he's blue. More like a design choice to contrast with his usual red color scheme.
Who cares about the importance of color scheme? We got more important things to discuss than character development and colors. Like Akuma's many feats, The dude has cracked mountains, jumped through the bottom of the ocean, erupted volcanoes of a punch, and even sunk a large bit of an island. Now, the island here doesn't have a specific name to it, so we use a general idea of a mountain's smallest size being 2,000 meters, and depth being around 20,000. Now, this meter here is a sin 4p, or 27 meters per pixel, making the mountain around 353p.
Which, in layman's terms, it's over 9,540 meters. Meaning for Akuma to make this explosion and to make the entire island disappear, he would need to be hitting it at around 1.7 megatons of force. But that's nothing compared to Shin Akuma. Oh, right, he's a thing. He only really exists for this feat. But look at him punching this giant meteor. Now the meteor itself, by our estimations, is around near 500 miles long. And to take account Akuma's base height and for him to fully destroy this meteor, he would need a near 2.3 petatons worth of force to fully destroy this meteor in Shin Akuma's state.
But the guy isn't just an unstoppable pile of pure power. He's also very fast. Not only can he scale to wield bullet time, but he also was able to tag M. Bison, who at one point was able to tag this laser satellite blast. Now the blast itself was most likely taking around 13 seconds to land, and Bison had to quickly get to it. So he had to be going at around 415 million kilometers per hour, meaning he was reaching speeds faster than light. And Akuma can catch the guy and surprise him, which led to his soul being attacked by the raging demon.
Akuma is so impressive, you'd be shocked that he has taken a few defeats before. He lost to Ryu multiple times to Gouken, and if he ever let the Satsumi no Hado take full control, he will lose the little humanity he has left. And he's also a much more preferred close-range fighter. Long range isn't what he's good with or against.
But then that's all the faults in a world full of blonde pyromancers, super soldiers, and a soul-weaponizing Nazi? None has truly been able to match the power and ferocity of Street Fighter's own demon of the martial arts, and it's Satsumi no Hado.
Imagine, if you will, a bloodline of warriors facing civil war. Practitioners of martial arts so deadly and determined that their sheer drive to kill each other literally brought forth the Third World War.
You might think such devotion to destroying your own bloodline would be impossible, but for the Mishimas, such a thing was just business. Literally. Their family company, the Mishima Zaibatsu, was an arms-dealing company that vastly grew in power during the Second World War, run by Jinpachi Mishima, who looks like his beard could double as a pitchfork.
Not too surprising, considering his son Heihachi can apparently sharpen his hair somehow. However, over time, Jinpachi grew to loathe the direction he took the company, so he started reducing the size of the company over time, until his son Heihachi took the company over, imprisoned him, and left him to get possessed by a demon.
Because, you know, that just happens.
Yeah, you know, for us, just, you know, it's Tuesday.
With the company now in his control, the Mishima Zaibatsu became the largest military developer in the world, all the while he lived a relatively peaceful life with his wife Kazumi, and their son, who would later prove to be his greatest undoing, Kazuya Mishima.
Yeah, although the family cared for each other over the first 5 years, tragedy soon struck when his wife Kazumi was possessed by a demon herself, and Heihachi was forced to kill her in self-defense. Naturally outraged, Kazuya stood up to his father to avenge his mother's death at the hands of the man he now hated most.
Only get his ass beat and tossed off a cliff. Father of the year, everybody!
Now more determined to get revenge, Heihachi, and having survived the fall, Kazuya would spend the next 21 years training for the day he could get what he deserved. And he knew just the way to do it.
You see, as is standard for more enigmatic billionaires in the fighting game genre, they have their own martial arts tournament as a side business for kicks, and Heihachi is no exception. The winner of the tournament would have to face Heihachi himself to walk away the true king of the Iron Fist.
One can barely imagine Heihachi's face when he saw Kazuya's name fly through the brackets. Maybe it came as a shock, maybe he'd expect nothing less, but one universal truth remained.
Kazuya was ready for the salty run back. And with a stupidly wide array of techniques from his family's very own martial arts, Mishima-style, fighting karate, he was more than ready for it.
Kazuya's fighting style employs a wide array of deep body stances, enabling leg strength, core stability, and explosive movement, designed to seize as much control of his opponent's body as possible. Such as the Demon Scissors technique, where he does a jumping splits, and the Stone Head, which is basically just a fairly strong headbutt.
A tsunami kick starts at the enemy's face, but he spins so hard his foot ends up on the top of their head. His electric wind gosh misses a powerful uppercut. Then, with powerful energy, Kazuya can use Inferno, which lets him shoot lasers from his mighty third eye. And if he really wants to show off to the enemy, he uses his glorious 10-hit combo, the best way to disinfect his foes.
And lastly, and certainly his strongest, is his powerful devil form. Which is interesting, unlike his son Gen Kazuma, who also has the devil form, Kazuya is able to fully control his own form. With it, he gains wings, powerful lasers, is even able to grab his opponents into the air and send them down at great speeds from such heights. Imagine like a Pokemon seismic toss.
Man, who knew every devil user is so badass? Wait, I'm basically a devil being the owner of this hell. Do I have devil gene powers?
I'm just gonna stand back. Just in case you somehow do it.
Aw. Real close.
Oh, calling me surprised. Well, did you all know a devil gene works differently based on the user? Like with Kazuya, his devil gene has four different states of activation. First phase, he keeps his normal human look, but can use his third eye. Second one, he gains a purple-like skin along horns and wings. He slowly looks more monster-like in his third state. And finally, phase four is when he fully becomes it. Fully rocking the devil form, you can say.
And you won't be shocked that the guy can also do much as well. Literally being one of the strongest guys in the world kinda helps you scale around some of the best events in your series. His lasers can cause a volcano to erupt. He can survive satellite lasers blast, point blank, easily fought and defeated Hahashi during the 4-3 match? Yeah, they fight a lot. And Hahashi was able to rip through these jack robots like butter, took an army of them blowing up into space.
For context, a much older model of the jack robot was able to destroy this meteor. Now, based on how heavy a meteor is, which is based on its size and structure, he fully worked out the volume of said meteor being around 94 billion pounds. And for the Jack Robot earlier model to fully collide and destroy this certain meteor in such a small fraction of time as he did, he would need to be hitting with around 4.7 petatons of TNT to do so. And remember, he and Hihachi are able to rip through much durable and stronger Jack models later on.
Now with speed, he's easy to compare him to Hihachi, who's able to catch bullets with his deep and even faster to protect Kazuya from his demon self's own laser. The same laser that was able to shoot a satellite down from orbit. Now where Kazuya at looks to be nearby Mishima Tower, right over there. Assuming the skyscraper he's on is on the lower end of a natural height being 150 meters tall, and Kazuya's on height is around 181 centimeters, he will add that and remove it for distance.
Now the satellite itself seemed to be around 200 kilometers in the air to 15 million kilometers in the air. And since the laser took around 6 seconds to hit the satellite, that must mean Kazuya's own laser is fast enough to go on 119 trillion kilometers an hour. A couple hundred times the speed of light.
And in the end, he defeated Hahachi in their final battle and fully let the devil in them out, tossing him in the volcano for a sweet taste of revenge. But really, that also helped cause an issue for the world. You see, with Kazuya's blindness for rage, he got to see he was doing the same to his son, Gen Kazuma, and it helped him unlock his own devil gene. I guess Kazuya in the end just restarted the cycle his own father started.
Everything you have, I will now take from you. Everything you thought you were, I have proven you are not.
Okay, the combatants are set. Let's settle this.
Will Akuma finally show the true power of the Setsui no Hado, or will Kazuya take in this victory with an iron fist?
It's time for these two fictional characters to collide.
You are very amusing.
Street Fighter almost had a W for once on this show. Can't we have nice things for once?
You know the answer to that question. But yes, sadly, it's true, Demon. But Akuma definitely went down swinging. Right next to a few certain episodes on the show, this fight was one of the closest we have ever seen. While both can cause eruptions and island-destroying feats in their base states, and can easily move at massively hypersonic speeds in base as well, the real question is, what could they do at their peak strength?
But to do that, we first need to compare a few certain feats of strength and speed to find out who has what in this fight. Let's start with Akuma's Meteor Punch feat compared to the Jack Robot Meteor feat. Now, with Akuma's feat, he had to do it in his Shin form, so it's reasonable that this isn't usable for his base. But right now, the feat itself is worth 2.3 petatons, the speed being around high hypersonic and faster than light scaling with the Bison 14-second laser tag feat.
But Kazuya can just scale to Heihachi, who defeated a much stronger Jack Robot than the one who destroyed this meteor, which was around 4.7 petatons. and his own laser attacks were able to reach this satellite in a matter of 6 seconds, giving him a higher number of FTL, meaning that Kazuya was not only twice as strong, but also at least 1.5 times faster, meaning that Kazuya was able to take and deal much more to Akuma, and his own attack speed is much quicker than anything Akuma has ever dodged or fought against.
But numbers isn't the only thing that really matters in this fight. Thanks to Kazuya's devil form, he has wings to fly in the air to have a much higher mobility than Akuma and full battlefield control, plus having greater combat spirits given he's been trained since he was a kid.
And thanks to Kazuya having much more very long-range attacks than Akuma, he could keep himself away from harm and just make sure Akuma can't make any major advancements without letting him get too close. Remember, Akuma is a guy who definitely prefers close-range attacks and doesn't usually depend on his long range. Meanwhile, Kazuya may have many close-range techniques, but he usually prefers taking them down from afar without getting his hands dirty, giving him a healthy mix of both rather than Akuma's main reliance on one.
But Archer, what about the Raging Demon? That move can surely give Akuma the win. Kazuya is literally just part devil. He would totally kill him if given the chance.
Yes, if he can get it off. But thanks to Kazuya's flight and the vast array of beings he fought as an experienced fighter, he most likely won't let Akuma come near him long enough to land such a devastating and dangerous move. Remember, Kazuya can be a very arrogant man with daddy issues, but he isn't stupid.
Yeah, Akuma looked a lot more badass and was the surefire winner on paper. But he just couldn't get past Kazuya's fight speed advantage, greater strength, better mobility, higher experience, and the much broader amount of long-range attack options he had.
Poor Akuma. I guess he just couldn't take the heat.
The winner is Kazuya Mishima.